Welcome to another exciting episode of The Marriage Educators. I'm Dr. Frank McKnight.
And I'm Janae McKnight.
And we're here to educate and elevate marriages and relationships.
Yes, and our last episode, we talked about smarter goals and about establishing goals in your marriage. And so we just want to thank you guys so much for the response that we have gotten. So we're going to open up this episode today with a question that we got from our viewers.
Okay. And just to read one, what do you do when you and your spouse do not share the same goals?
Okay. So in this case, if it's a goal that someone, whether it's the wife or the husband, and they decide that, let's say they say, I want to buy a car, but the other mate is not on board. Mm-hmm. And so again, a lot of times in marriage, we know that you have to compromise. And so one of the things would be to sit down and see how that goal will benefit both parties, and benefit your family as a whole. And so then, you know, sometimes you may not totally be into it, but you will get into it. Because I remember when you were wanting to buy your new car,
right,
and I remember I was thinking, it's not time. And I kind of was not on board with it at that time.
But
you started praying about it. You were budgeting it out. You were going to the dealership, walking around the dealership, looking up cars. I was like,
confessing,
oh, my God.
Confessing, praying.
Yes. And so at first I did not get an agreement. I'm not going to lie. I was like, we're not getting this car. But eventually, as I saw that he was so set on it, and then I thought about how it would benefit our family. And then I also thought about how he was driving an unsafe vehicle. Because when I tell you he was driving a car that the bumper was duct taped on.
And the horn didn't even work.
And the horn didn't work. Nope. And so we were like, okay, I thought about, you know, unselfishly, I said, I want my husband to be safe when he's going to and from. And so we ended up getting on board with that. So be open and be willing to compromise. That's what I would say to that question.
All right. And then we also got a comment or a testimony from Melissa and Derek from Milwaukee. She says here, I've always wanted to start my own beauty salon. My husband has always been supportive, and we set this as a goal, and we put our faith together, and we confessed, we saved. The Lord found us a spot nearby, and we wrote our goals down. We made a vision board, and to God be the glory, I have my own beauty salon. And we're enjoying the profits, and we have been enjoying it and being a blessing to others. Love you guys. Keep up the good work.
Oh, wow. Good. Congratulations to that couple.
Right, right. So again, you know, we want couples to make sure, listen, set goals together.
Yes.
Write it down. Last time we met, we talked about couples coming together, setting goals for their marriage and for their lives. We looked at the smarter goals, which is your goals have to be specific.
Yes.
They've got to be measurable.
Yes.
You got to be able to check and make sure that you're right on target with those goals. They have to be achievable.
Yes.
Okay. And we said that even in being achievable, we know that God can help us, you know, to achieve it. Because the scripture says in Philippians, we can do all things through Christ. So if we've got that determination, we can certainly make sure those goals are achievable. Then we also said that those goals have to be relevant, something that we both want to accomplish, we both want to do. And then we said that those goals have to be time-based.
Yes.
Which means that your goal has to have a deadline, has to have an ending date.
Yes.
Now, you can make more goals beyond that. However, whatever goal you set, you want to make sure that there's an end to that goal. And then we said E is to what?
Evaluate.
And that means
that you need to go back over your goals to see if you're being progressive and successful. And then it may also mean that you have to reestablish your goals. You may have to reset sometimes and change it around a little bit.
Right, because sometimes life happens, so you have to kind of evaluate to make sure if you need to make any changes on that. And then the R is rejoice.
Yes.
Meaning that once you reach that goal, celebrate. First of all, thank God, praise God for allowing you to accomplish it. And then you as husband and wife can celebrate it, whether it's getting that new home, that new car, starting that family, completing that degree. And that's going to kind of lead us into what we want to talk about today.
Yes.
Is what type of goals can we set?
Because
there's so many different types of goals. And so we're going to take the time to discuss the types of goals couples, you know, can actually set. Now that we know how to set goals, what are some goals that couples can begin to set for themselves?
Right. And our first category is financial goals.
That's a big one.
Yes. Okay. As we know that finances, which we'll do a different episode on that later, but finances is a major thing in marriage, especially when you are bringing two financial incomes together and sharing all of the financial responsibilities together. So one of the things is that you may want to start a savings plan. So both parties would need to be on board with that. You would have to agree to having either having one savings account where money is deposited into it, what schedule you're going to have as far as with that, the promise to each other not to touch it, so that you can actually build the savings. And we'll talk later, but I just want to encourage you to make sure you find a good savings. Sometimes you may go with an online savings account to get more interest as opposed to going to a bank.
And then also another financial goal, and this was something actually we did early in our marriage. We had a lot of credit card debt, and we had credit cards from, you know, from every store that you could name. And we realized, like, we don't need 12 and 13 and 14 different credit cards. And so one of our financial goals was to cut up, get rid of all of those cards. And we went to a meeting at, I think it was at the UIC Pavilion. I believe it was either Creflo Dollar and Leroy Thompson or another ministry. And they spoke about getting out of debt. And so we took those credit cards and we prayed every day, put those cards in a box, and we prayed over them and asked God, Lord, we want to be free from this credit card debt. And we could see ourselves coming out of and climbing out of debt, cutting those cards in half and so forth. So getting out of debt can certainly be a financial goal that a couple can have.
As well as a college savings plan for your children.
Right.
So you can also agree to set aside or start a college savings plan for your children. And you have, again, the goals with that is that's a smarter goal because you're going to set the time limit that your child will be of age to go to college. And you have a goal of having enough money for them to go to college without needing to borrow from anyone. So that is also another goal that you can set for your children.
Right. And then you mentioned saving and, you know, also saving for a rainy day, but also saving for maybe a project that, that you as a couple may want to do, maybe finish your basement or a project of saving for a down payment or what have you. So there's a lot of different types of financial goals that a couple can set. And again, you know, make sure you're specific. Like, honey, we want to get rid of these three credit cards. We got to be specific. We have to measure it, make sure we're cutting them down. And then we got to be time-based in the sense of we want to be out of this credit card debt by January 2021 or what have you. So again, these are things that, that you can implement as a couple.
Absolutely. And our next topic is recreational goals. So for example, you may want to have a recreational goal of painting. You know, I know like a lot of times people call it like their bucket list, something that they want to do. Some people say it's not necessarily a big, big thing, but it may be like you may want to learn how to swim. I know there's a lot of people that they go on vacation and they can't do any of the water activities because they don't know how to swim. And so again, you don't have to stay stuck. You don't have to stay bound and afraid from childhood of the water. I know a good and dear friend and her husband took swim lessons because they knew they were going on a great vacation where they were going to beaches and they were going to be in the ocean and the water. And they did not want to be bound by, I'm afraid to swim. So they went and they learned how to swim together as a couple. Again, that's like, it's not a date night, but it's like a date day. And you get to go swimming together with your instructor. And so when you're doing that, you know, you get to learn how to swim and then it will benefit you. So that is a great recreational goal. So that's one of the things that you can do in that category.
Right. So and then also you may have a goal of working out, you know, you know, exercising. You may have a goal of recreational goal of as a couple taking up maybe tennis lessons or, you know, bowling. You know, there are many couple leagues that are out there now. And you may say, you know, hey, you know, one of our goals is to learn how to bowl, improve our bowling score together.
Yes.
It's a wonderful couples thing that one can do. So, so really, it's limitless of the different recreational or fun things that you as a couple can do. And a lot of times people think all goals have to be serious-minded. It's got to be financial, has to be career-wise. But you can set recreational goals, fun goals that you want to do to enjoy each other, as well as to reach an objective.
Absolutely. So, mm-hmm. So like this year, I want us to set a goal that we're going to go get massages.
Ah, I like that. Okay.
And spend the spa day.
Spa day. See that?
Somebody has a birthday coming. So,
oh, yeah.
Yes.
I wonder who that is.
Right. Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. Okay. So, yes, absolutely. That's my word. All right. So, I want to do that.
All right.
Okay. Next is our category of educational goals.
Yeah, educational goals is a very important one. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're married and let's say you want to get either an advanced degree or a certification or a license, you know, you can certainly do that. I know a couple now where the husband has wants to be a realtor. And so the wife is supporting him in getting his real estate license. And so that could be a goal. Because again, when you think about goals, both individually and collectively, like we said last time, everybody in the family benefits from that.
Yes.
And so with him doing that, that's going to mean more money, that's going to mean more income and so forth. So we want to encourage you to definitely set some educational goals for you. And again, whether it's that degree, certificate, or learning a language. I know one couple is learning French because they're getting ready to go to France. So it could be so many different types of educational goals or learning goals that you can set for yourself, you know, as a couple.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And another category is business and career goals. Mm-hmm. So you can also set a goal together to start a business together.
Yes. Yes.
We are seeing many couples doing this, and probably a later show will also be about that. Mm-hmm. But we definitely want you guys to know that you can start a business. And a lot of times when you get your mate on board with your business and you join together, you are much more effective, because we all know about the power of agreement and how when two or three of you come together, when you do that, when you come together and you are praying about it, you're both in agreement about it, and you are doing your business together, it's so much sweeter and it's so much more pleasant to do together. So, yes, so that is another goal that you could set, that you want to have a business. When do you want it to start? What are some of your end goals? What do you want to accomplish with this business? And so set those goals for your business together, too.
Right. And then also, one spouse may have a specialty in one area and the other spouse may not. And so that spouse can certainly be supportive and be there to lend a helping hand or what have you. If one spouse might be, you know, good in marketing and sales and wants to open up a restaurant, and the other spouse might not know anything about cooking or whatnot, that spouse can still support that husband, can do whatever she can to help him in that particular business if that's what he's really, really good at.
Yes.
And again, the benefits really work together to help the couple. So, yeah, you could certainly start a business together. And then we also kind of set career goals as well. You know, just even as when I think about, you know, ourselves and the career goals, you know, moving up in the company or moving up in the area that you want to work in. I know you started out as a teacher, kindergarten, first grade, and then went up to middle school and then high school and now instructional coach and dean or what have you. So you know, there can be certain career goals that couples can have where they want to move up or advance within their chosen career field. And so, you know, when my wife would make decisions or ask questions, I was there to pray about it, consider it, to talk about it, to talk it through. Because again, when it comes to goal setting, that communication is really, really key.
Yes.
Because you want to know, what does this mean for us as a couple in reaching and achieving this particular goal?
Absolutely. And just adding a little bit onto that is that it also means you have to ask, like a lot of times I would talk with my husband about before taking a promotion. I know some people get so excited they just take the promotion and they don't even talk about it, but some promotions will involve more time. They will involve more time away from home. And so you want to talk to your entire family and see, is this something that we can do? Is this something that we can do for a short amount of time? Because again, there goes that time element. It may not be forever, but it may be for a year or two, just like with your degree. We knew it was a couple of years, and we were willing to make the sacrifice for those years so that you could accomplish that goal. Same thing with a promotion. You want to set a goal. How many years will I be working like this and doing this? And then you want to see, are you willing as a family, as a spouse, to support through that period? And so, yeah, that's very important.
Right. And then, as you mentioned, in discussing it, looking through that whole SMART goal and that evaluate, you know, is this something that's going to benefit? Well, what are some of the negative, the pros and the cons? And there's nothing wrong with doing that. And then asking the Lord for his help and his guidance, because he's there to help us to make, you know, the right decision. You know, I think about the scripture in Proverbs where it says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to our own understanding. But in all of our ways, even when it comes to goals and certain decisions, the Lord says he'll direct our path. And so that's that God factor that we always want to include when it comes to setting goals for our lives. So we set business, career goals, we set financial goals, educational goals. Is there any more?
Spiritual.
Ah, spiritual goals.
And you kind of just weaved right into that.
Right, right, right. So spiritual goals is a very interesting one because, again, a lot of people don't talk about, well, how do you have a spiritual goal? Well, as married couples, you certainly can. It can start as praying together. You know, we have a goal of praying, whether it's either every day, every other day, or what have you. That could be considered a spiritual goal. Another spiritual goal is increased Bible time, you know, or reading a Christian book and sharing one with another.
Yes.
You know, my wife's a definitely an avid reader. And so for her to read and then share some of the things that, that she's gotten out of the book, or as I'm studying the Word and I get a revelation, we can kind of share. So having that time of just talking about the Lord, talking about the Word, you know, can be a set goal that we have. So that's one spiritual goal.
And even with spiritual goals, like, you know, you can also read other books. Like sometimes people feel like it has to be, you know, like a, you know, real spiritual or real deep book. And that's great. Yes, do that. Definitely get that knowledge, get that understanding. As educators, we definitely promote that. But then sometimes you may just want to read a book that is a personal self-help book, such as there's a book that I was reading and it helps you to overcome, you know, fear as far as when you get in front of large crowds or audiences and things along that manner. And so that's something that can help you to discover some things that may be hidden down deep inside of you that you want to overcome. And again, that's a goal of yours that, you know what, hey, I'm tired of being afraid of this. I'm tired of doing this. So now I want to do something about it. And then you can share that with your mate about how you are in that process of working on yourself, yourself improving yourself in that area of your life. And so there's many books out there that you can get to help you in those different areas. Again, never stay stuck. Never stay stuck.
Right. And then I wanted to add another spiritual goal is as couples choosing maybe a different ministry within your local church that you as a couple can become involved in. We for ourselves have, you know, been a part of different ministries and we have set, you know, certain goals for ourselves. This particular broadcast is one of our spiritual goals. To reach out and to help other couples. And so one of the things is that, you know, think about God's purpose in your marriage and what kind of goals can we set that can affect the kingdom, that can help fulfill our purpose, whether it's working with youth, whether it's working with married couples, whether it's working with teacher training, Bible school or what have you. There's so many things for the kingdom that we as couples can do and you as couples can do in order to effect change and to advance, you know, the kingdom of God. So do think about setting some spiritual goals that, that you and your spouse can do, you know, and accomplish. So those are spiritual goals, all right? What are some other goals that a couple can set? Because we've got quite a few, don't we?
Yes. Another category is intimate goals.
Intimate goals, yes.
So I want to start this one with recently I saw a video, and on this video it was like a part one and a part two to an anniversary celebration. And I thought that was just so, so very nice, such a great idea. Now, I'm not gonna make my husband feel guilty because he didn't think of this first, but it was a, the part two. I didn't get to see the part one of the anniversary celebration, but the part two, the guy actually had someone come to their house and They serenaded and professionally sang and played for his wife. He had roses that he like put on the floor. So when she opened the door, she saw the roses. Another time they had roses and they had money. And I was like, oh my goodness, goals right there. You know, that's relationship goals. So I'm just letting you guys know that, you know, be as creative as possible. Again, you know, hey, it's okay to, you know, talk to your fellas and see who can be the most romantic. Ladies, you know, who can be the most romantic? What can we do to please our mates? What can we do in this intimate setting? Because a lot of times you hear intimate and you automatically think that it's about the bed, but intimacy begins way ahead of that. And so, again, it's a lot of different things that you can do. Just sweet notes, text messages, emails, you know, heart emojis, you know, and I know some people use other emojis.
Flowers. Flowers.
They use other emojis, but we're just going to stick.
The emojis.
Yeah, we're going to wait for that one for the Let's Talk About Sex episode. But people use all different types of ways to just, you know, celebrate their loved ones, just to let them know that they're thinking about them.
Right, right.
Yes.
And another important intimate goal is, you know, setting a goal of getting away.
Yes.
You know, every year or twice a year, you know. We have a goal of during the Valentine's season, we get away, we leave the state,
absolutely.
And do do something together. So that could be considered an intimate goal as well. Other intimate goals could be having set date nights.
Yes.
You know, I know one a couple, they do a date night every other Friday or something along that line. So you can kind of set those goals, but again, you have to be purposeful. You got to stick with it. Did I measure it? Am I able to do it? Did I meet this deadline for this particular goal or what have you? So that can certainly be, you know, considered an intimate goal as well.
Yes. And our next category is family goals.
Family goals.
Yes.
All right. So how do you, what's a family goal? How would you define that?
Well, the first thing is you want to set a family goal early on in marriage of how big you want your family.
Yes.
You know, I don't think that it's just a thing where it's like, oops, I have 12 kids. No.
No.
Kids
should
be planned if you can.
Right.
Because they have, you know, they have a future and they're going to be with you for 18 years. And I know years ago people would have 12 kids and all like that. And if that's your goal and your desire, plan for it. But first of all, plan as far as like what, how large you want your family to be. Again, we can't determine male or female, that's God's choice. But at the same time, you know, plan for that part.
Right, right. Another family goal could be family vacations, you know, family outings. You know, setting a goal that once a month we're going to go out as a family, either out to eat or we're going to the museum or we're going to pick something to do, whether it's once a month or every other month or however your schedule, you know, commits. So you can set certain, you know, family goals. It could be a family goal of the whole family working out together. It could be a family goal of working on a particular project, you know, in the home or something along those lines.
Yes.
So, so it's kind of really endless when we talk about family goals. I know one family, the extended family, set a family goal of every fifth Sunday they get together and have family soul food dinner. You know, that's a goal of the every fifth Sunday we're going to get together at Big Mama's house and we're going to eat and we're going to just enjoy each other. That's a family goal. So your family goal can be as big as a vacation to as small as going out to eat or doing something you know, fun with the kids. So.
And I know another family that their family goal is, especially to teach their children. I'm big on this about teaching children how to serve others.
Yes.
They make sure that they go and serve others in some capacity or another, whether they go to a soup kitchen, whether they go out and feed the homeless, whether they go out and donate bags or purses to those in need on the street, but they make sure that they go and do those types of things so that they can teach their children not to live an entitled life. That's a whole nother show, talking about training and teaching your children about, you know, it's not what I can put in your hand, but it's about what I can put in your heart and in your head.
So important.
That's a whole nother episode. But anyway, that's another family goal that you can make to go and serve and be a blessing to others instead of just yourself.
And then the last goal that we had, we're looking at, is physical goals.
Yes.
And that can be anywhere from losing weight to getting in shape. Physical goal could be being doing a sporting activity, joining the softball league or some type of physical exertion type activities, which to help to lose weight or what have you. So
Absolutely.
that's what I would kind of consider, a physical goal. And we as couples can support each other in doing that,
Yes.
So we definitely want to think about, considering a physical goal as well.
And you can even have a goal of how much water you want to make sure that you each drink in a day or in a week. You can do little fun challenges with each other. Like, today, did you drink your gallon of water? Yeah, I drank my gallon. And you can do all of those types of things together. And then you can also, again, you can kind of work with each other on different areas. Maybe you want those arms that you see, you're like, okay, I don't want my arms to jiggle when I wave. So that's something that you can be like, let's work on this together. Let's do some arm routines together, get you some weights, get you some dumbbells, and do what you need to do with that. But yeah, those physical goals are very, very, very realistic as well. And those are goals that you want to set with each other. Also, another physical goal that you may want, and this kind of fits into this category a little bit, is like, for example, if you are on medication, set a goal with your mate that you are going to do everything possible to come off that medication.
Yes,
There are
that's
some people
definitely.
that are like, they feel like they're supposed to be, they have to be on this medication forever, but there are healthy and natural ways
That's
for you
right.
to eliminate medication. So you can set that goal with your mate that, hey, you know what? I'm coming off of this blood pressure medicine. So what I'm going to do, I'm not just going to stop cold turkey. But what I am going to do is I'm going to start drinking more water. I'm going to start getting that daily cardio in and doing what I can do. And then the next time, we're going to come in agreement and believe God that the doctor will take me
Yes,
off of this
and he can do
medication. So
that.
you should set goals even for that type of stuff. And that's great. That's great.
Right. So, as we kind of wrap up with goals and the type of goals, just a few things that we want to remind you is that when it comes to goal setting, with you and your mate, come together, talk about it, discuss it. Talk about where you want to be in 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. What's your aspirations? Is so important. Plan your future together, okay? Because hey, we're in it for the long haul. So let's plan a great and a bright future when we're in our 30s, 40s, 50s, and 60s, or what have you. And then also pray over your goals. Come together as a couple to pray over our goals and our future.
Yes, and touch and agree.
Touch and agree. Pray for God's help. Because he can help you. He has sent his Holy Spirit to help us to achieve our goals. And then also we want to pray for God to lead us in the decisions that we make, as it relates to our marriage and relates to the goals that we have set for ourselves. And then praise God for the outcome.
Yes, yes.
Celebrate those successes when we meet those goals. Encourage each other. When we have met the goals that we have set for ourselves, and that's that part where we talk about rejoice. Okay,
Yes.
and then the final thing I just want to reiterate: the sky is the limit.
Absolutely.
You can set whatever goals you want. Pray over them, believe God for them,
Yes.
work together. It's exciting when we reach those goals and come near the end of those goals, okay?
So we're going to get ready to wrap up our show, but we just want to remind everyone, if you have any further questions, if we didn't answer your question or you didn't get to share, we didn't get to share your testimony today, please email us your comments at kingdommarriages2018@gmail.com. Also, like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at The Marriage Educators. And we look forward to seeing you guys on our next episode.
All right,
And
and we're signing out. Okay. And we are the marriage educators. We are educating and elevating.